Get your free copy of the complete tutorial at www.teachucomp.com/free.
Let's examine how we can create point type text in Elements. Point type allows you to create text where each line of text is independent of the other lines. In Elements, you can create either horizontal or vertical text. As you type, the length of the line will grow. If you delete characters, the line of text will shrink. However, the line will not wrap to the next line of text. To create a point type text layer, click on one of the type tools from the Tools palette. So we'll go ahead and do that. We'll right click to see our choices, and we'll just select Horizontal Type Tool for now. Now your mouse pointer will then turn into an I-beam character that we see here. And this character marks what's called the baseline of the text. The baseline is the line upon which the text will rest. You simply click into the image at the place where you want the text baseline to appear, just like that. Next, you use the options bar to set your font options. Let's take a look. First, we have the font dropdown to select which typeface you want to use for your text. All these different choices. And we'll scroll up and see we have many different choices here. We'll just pick good old-fashioned Arial. Now, after that, you have what's called the font style dropdown located right here. And that allows you to set whether the text is regular, bold, italic, etc. Now, this changes for each type of font typeface. Some of the font typefaces that you might choose might not even have these choices, or none at all, other than regular. Next, you use the font size dropdown to set the size of the font in points. You can select one of the predetermined sizes, or if you prefer, you can go up into the text box and enter a value manually. After that, you then set what's called the anti-aliasing mode for the text using this toggle button right here. When turned on, it prevents jagged text edges if you select one of the following choices that we're going to talk about, these buttons right here. These next few buttons allow you to add faux bold, faux italic, underline, and even strike through text. Faux means that if the font that you choose doesn't have either a bold or an italic version, this feature will change the text to mimic the effect. And to turn those on, you just click them. They're toggle buttons as well. Turn them on and turn them off. The next dropdown that we have, which is three different buttons if you're using version 5.0, allows you to set the alignment of your text. You can select the left align button to align multiple lines of text by their left sides, center text to align multiple lines of text by their horizontal center points, or right align to right align the text lines. We'll leave that at center for now. Next, we have what's called leading. That's this right here. And leading determines the amount of space between the baselines. The default leading setting is auto, and that's where Elements will use 120% of the type point font size. Basically, what that does is it keeps the top and bottom of your text lines from bumping into one another. After that, you click the font color. And that will launch the color picker. We've seen this many times where you can choose a color and then click OK. Now you can also click the warp text button right to the right of that, which will launch the warp text dialog box where you can apply a shape to your text if you want. You simply use the style dropdown and make your choices. And you can play around with these and find one that you might want. Right now we'll leave it at none. After you make your choice, you just click OK. Now you can also change your text orientation easily by clicking the Change Text Orientation button and toggling between horizontal and vertical choices. And that's located right here. Simply click it. Now, after setting your desired options, you type the text that you want using your keyboard. Let's go ahead and do that. Just like that. When you're done, you go back up into the options bar and you click the confirm green check mark button right here to save your changes, or to cancel your changes, you just click the cancel button right to the left of it. Now let's look at how we can create paragraph text in Elements. When you enter paragraph text, the lines of type will wrap to fit the dimensions of its bounding box. You can enter in multiple lines of text easily here with a paragraph alignment that you set up in the options bar. We just looked at that. You can then change the size of the bounding box to change the flow of the text within the bounding box. You can do this while you're entering text or later after creating the text. You can also use the bounding box to rotate, scale, and skew the type in the bounding box. So to create paragraph text, select one of the type tools like we did before, give it a click, and after you've done that, you simply click and drag to create your bounding box, just like that. Then you set your options up in the options bar, just like we did before, and we'll leave them set where we have them. And then after that, you type the text that you want into the bounding box. Just like that. Now, you can then, when you're done, press Enter on your keyboard to create a new paragraph if you like. Unlike point text, however, you don't need to press Enter to create a new line within the same paragraph, as the text will automatically wrap when it encounters the edge of the bounding box. Now, if you type more text than the bounding box can hold, as I've done here, you'll see a small icon appear that looks like a square divided into four quadrants, right down in the bottom right-hand corner. That icon indicates that the text is overflowing the bounding box, so you can resize, rotate, or skew the bounding box to adjust it as you type the text if needed, or after we're done. So we can just click on the double arrows to increase the size that way. You can click on it like that, and we're going to look at some different options. You can even rotate it by clicking till it turns into a double pointed curved arrow like that, and we'll look at some of these other choices in some of the upcoming lessons. Now when you're finished, again you go up into the options bar and click either the commit button to commit the changes of the text or the cancel button. Well, this time we'll click commit and you'll see that we've entered our text.
Like what you see? Pick up your free copy of the complete tutorial at www.teachucomp.com/free.